Hey guys, this is Eve with Scrapbooking with Me, and today we're going to make these cute little book boxes. They look like a little book, but you can store things in them. I just have some of my Graphic 45 cutouts in there. And you can make them any size that you want. This one's a little bit larger. It's one of them that I've had for a while. And you can make them any color. But as you can see, you can use them for your storage. You can put them on a shelf and make them look like real books. Alright, so all I did to begin with is I just cut out, these are just my Graphic 45 little cutouts that come in your paper pack. And you don't have to use this if you don't use Graphic 45 paper. You can use anything. You can get just a piece of paper and cut out a piece as big as you want your book binding to be. As tall as you want your book binding to be. You can make them larger. You know, you can make one this size if you wanted to. You just have to adjust your measurements. You need just a little bit at the top to fold over. A little bit at the bottom to fold over, and then a little bit on the sides to fold over to make your book binding. But other than that, you can make these out of anything. It doesn't have to be these little cards. I just happen to have these, and I like them. I like the looks of them, so that's what I did. Then you're going to need two pieces of chipboard, and this is just some white chipboard that I got out of a packaging or whatever. 3 1/8 by 3, and I will have all of these measurements on my blog. It's just, I know it's hard to keep up with measurements on here, but these are 3 1/8 by 3. Then you're going to need two pieces that are 1 1/2 by 2 7/8, and then you're just going to need either a craft cardstock, or this time I'm going to use this brown because it matches my what I'm going to use for my binding. So you're going to, this piece, you're going to need two pieces of this that are 4 by 4. This is the cardstock. Two pieces that are 2 7/8 by 3. Two pieces that are 2 1/8 by 3. No, one piece that is 2 1/8 by 3. And then one piece that is 1 1/2 by 5 7/8. I have to get that just right where I can read my writing. Okay, so what I did to start with is I flipped this over, and I knew that I needed to have a little bit of turn down to the top, a little bit of fold, a little bit of fold at the bottom. So what you want to do is find your image on the front that you want to make sure that shows on the end of your box like this, and just measure down, you know, so that your image will show like that. And if you don't have a particular image on there, then you don't have to worry about it. And then just fold up that amount. And I just scored it. What I did is laid this down. I figured out where I wanted my top to fold. And then I drew me some lines, and I just scored it at the top there. And then I just folded this up there. And that makes it the width of my little side pieces. And all this will, you'll understand more of this as we go along. It's kind of hard to explain it at this point. But I went ahead and drew out my boxes on here, my lines, so that when I put this on, I can get it straight. Because I'm terrible about getting things not so straight. Okay, so we're going to start with covering these. And I'm just going to use some glue. This glue sticks very well, and I don't seem to have a problem with it. So I'm going to use this. And I just kind of center it up on these pieces. You just need a little bit to turn over the sides, just like you're covering any other type of chipboard or book board, whatever. Just press it down really well. And I usually flip it over. You can see I got a little glue on that, but it's not going to matter because I'm going to put some decorations on the front of mine. Just flip it over and give it a little press just to make sure that I've got... I'm going to go ahead and erase this. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to score right down the edges of this so that we can turn that up. And I'm not going to pull out my scoreboard. I'm just going to use my ruler and my scoring tool on here. That's all I'm going to do. You can pull out your scoreboard if you want to. That makes it easier for you. This just makes the paper fold up better. Keeps it from cracking. And now just go ahead and give it a pre-fold. And then I take my scissors and I fold this over on my corner there. And then that tells me where I need to cut to make some good corners. And now, at this point, I use my score tape because it seems to just grab a lot quicker than using the glue, but you can use whichever one you want. It doesn't matter. And then you just want to peel this off and fold that side up and press it down. I go to the opposite side, fold that side up and press it down. And then one of the ends. And what I do right here, where you see that little lip right there, I take my bone folder and I just crease that little lip so that it will fold up nicely and give you a good crisp corner. See? Sometimes if you don't do that, it'll bulk out a little bit on you. So just take it and crease it with your bone folder and then fold it up. And you have some nice corners. Okay. All right, so that's that one. So when you have your pieces covered, you're going to make sure that your 3 1/8 is this way. So this is my 3 1/8. So I want to put it down just like this. And then my 3 1/8 just like this. And I am just going to use some glue. You can use score tape here or glue. It doesn't matter. I just use my wet glue here because it works great. Make sure that you get it right at your lines, right at your folds. Okay, now I'll tell you a secret about some of this paper. Some of the more expensive paper that's thicker, it tears very, very easily. I don't worry about that. What I do is I take my glue and I go on this side and that side, put a little glue on there, and then just kind of rub it in, let it sit a little bit. That glue will reinforce that and glue it right back together, but you just got to let it sit just a little bit. And it's clear, so it will dry clear, so you won't have a place on your book. Okay, so while that glue is drying, we're going to take this piece, and this piece is going to go in here. So I'm going to turn it over where I don't have my writing on that side. And it doesn't have to be exact, just as long as it covers that inside part right there. Just kind of center it up and then press it down. That reinforces that this end piece. Okay, then you want to take this, and I just put my glue in there and just wrap it around your glue. That's going to give you the fold or the bend that it needs. Or you can take it over the edge of your desk. Take a bone folder, break down the fibers. Now what you want to do is take this, the ends, and fold them up and glue them or score tape them, whatever. And they may be a little bit stubborn at first, and they may act like they don't want to bend, but just give them a little bit of help with the bone folder. And I always run glue right in the corner where it is folding, and that will help reinforce that to keep it from tearing, because it'll make that paper just a little bit wet, and then it will reinforce the fibers in it. Okay, and then do the other end. Same way. Just try to get you a good even fold. And if you need help from the bone folder, then just press it in there. Okay. Okay, that looks good. And you know what I did? And you don't do this, but I did it. This piece, you're supposed to wait until you fold these up and put it down. So Make sure you do that one on yours. Just the little center piece that's here. Fold these corners up and then put that center piece down, and that will hide these raw edges right here. But I think I might just put another piece in there to cover it up, because that will just help reinforce my book anyway, so it's not a problem. I'm just showing you what not to do. Make sure you put, you fold up your ends first and then put down this center piece, and you'll see the difference. See how it looks a lot more finished. Take our glue bottle and just kind of roll it. That should work. There we go. Okay, we're going to have a good, nice binding. And see where you get these little white breaks in the paper? Don't worry about that, because we're going to ink it all up. So now we're going to put these pieces down. And just make sure that they cover up your little folds, and that they cover up all of the white chipboard. I have so much glue on my fingers. Here you go. Excuse me. Now I take my bone folder and I run it back down through here, through the little corner a few times. That just helps it fold a little bit. I don't run it too many, because the more you fool with this paper, the better chance you have of it tearing. So I just run it down through there a few times to give it a little bit of a fold. There we go. Okay, we're almost finished. Now all you have to do is take your pieces that are 1.5 by 2 7/8, and you're going to put these down, put the chipboard down on that. Make sure I'm in frame. So put the chipboard right to the end. And then just make sure that it's covered with the brown cardstock. And it doesn't have to be perfect. You'll see why in just a minute. Then you're going to take the end, and I run my bone folder here too on the end of this, because you want this to bend backward. Then you're going to take this other piece and you're going to put it right on the end of that one, so that you can make your L. This will make the book part of it. See how I laid it down just on the end of that? And I'm going to hold it just a few minutes. I'll even put a little bit more glue in here just to kind of reinforce that. And all you're going for is that corner like that. All right, now I like to cover the other side of my insert. So go ahead and if it's a little long, just trim it off. But I like to cover this side as well. So what I do is lay another piece up there the same length, and I just go ahead and make my fold. And then put my glue on here and on here. Then I just put this one down on top of it. That way I keep my fold, I keep my little L, but I'm able to cover the other side too. And just press it down, and like I said, it doesn't matter if it's exactly the same width. It's good if it is, but it doesn't have to be. Excuse me. Okay, now what you're going to do, you're going to make sure that you've got your up part of your book. Like this is my top. And you're going to glue this to the bottom and then up the side, just like that. So I run a little bead of glue on here. And I don't know if all the glue would work the same. This art glitter glue works fantastic for this because it dries really fast. You could use hot glue here. And now I try to put it down without getting glue in too many different places. But if I do, I don't worry about it because it will dry clear. So you just want to put the end right up to your fold right there. Bring it down as straight as you can. And then this end, just like that. And I just take one of the little Q-tips like you use to clean your computer with. And I just run it along and get my extra glue off. Like I said, you don't have to worry about it because it does dry clear. So if a little bit's left on there, it's not a problem. Then you just want to hold it for just a little while until that glue catches. Then you can go ahead and put your glue bead on the top. Then take your book . Put it together just like that . Just pull your sides together, and you're gonna have to hold them for a while until it dries pretty good, or you can put a rubber band around it and let it sit for a little while. If you're using hot glue, you won't have to do that. It should dry really quick. But this glue will take just a little while because there is a little bit of tension on this to come apart because of this binding here. So I'm just going to hold it for a little bit. That put together, you are finished with exception of your inking or decorating or whatever, I'm going to take my pit pen, and where you see this little white chipboard right here, I'm just going to run my brown pit pen over that to cover that up, because I don't want that white to show. And anywhere else that you might see a little bit of white, you can run it over there. But then I'm going to use my Ground Espresso from Tim Holtz. And I'm just going to do a little inking on the edges. This will just kind of give it a little distressed look, like an older book, and it'll cover up any white parts that you had that might have the paper, where the paper might have broke, like right there. See how that just covers that up? And that is it. That is your little book. Now you can put some decorations on there if you want to. Let's see what we got. On the front, what might we want to put on the front? Oh, that's too big. I like that on there. So we'll ink this up a little. And I think I might put a word from the word stickers here. Let's see what. Let's put wonder, and then that says magic, like that. So we'll ink around the edges of this. And even though this does have adhesive on the back, I'm going to put a little more, because I don't want it to come off. And I think I'll offset it like that. And then I will put some adhesive on the back of this. And I think we'll put it right there. So that is it. That's your little book. Put these together so you can see them. Two little books. And if you wanted to make a bunch of these and then just glue them together here like that, then you could have lots of storage down your desk. And if you're worried about, you know, putting some small things in it in this little hole right here, just take a piece of chipboard or something and just put right up there on the bottom. Just cut you a little curve and put up there on the bottom to cover that in. It's not a big deal. You know, if you're storing pens or something like that in there, like, you know, if I wanted to store these, that would work. But if you wanted to store something a little smaller that you're afraid might fall through that little hole, then just cover it up on the bottom, because, you know, you're not gonna, nobody's gonna look at the bottom anyway. So there you go. That's the little book. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, or if you have any questions at all, please feel free to ask. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.